Hello everybody, welcome to iExamBee's Legal Bee. This is Amrita, your law faculty here at iExamBee. Embrace the iExamBee learning experience with us. In this video today, I'm going to continue with the series of conceptual videos that I have started exclusively on iExamBee's law channel Legal Bee. Don't forget to subscribe to Legal Bee and stay tuned with us for all such kind of beneficial content that we keep on providing you here at iExamBee. If you are preparing for any competitive examinations after your law, then you are at the right place. Check out all the online courses available for various examinations on our iExamBee's website. आप इन courses के demo भी activate करके देख सकते हैं. कोई भी queries हो, reach out to us by writing us an email on hello@iExamBee.com. You can also call us on the number 920-552-4028 and visit our website. You can also write to us in the comment section of this videos. If you have any queries, download our app for preparing 50% faster for jobs and also competitive examinations. The topic that we are going to discuss in this particular video today is mini constitution, that is 42nd constitutional amendment. 42nd constitutional amendment, why is it known as the mini constitution? What is the reason for it? This is also a constitutional amendment, but this is not like the other ordinary constitutional amendments. The things that are special about this amendment is that it has made various landmark changes in the constitution. Some of the changes were not very much welcomed, were actually reversed or repealed later on by subsequent amendments as well. There were some landmark contributions as well, for example, fundamental duties. वो भी तो 42nd कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट से ही ऐड किया गया था. तो ये सबसे ज़्यादा कॉन्ट्रोवर्जियल अमेंडमेंट भी हो कहा जा सकता है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन का, एंड काफ़ी लेंदी भी है क्योंकि इसमें काफ़ी सारे क्लॉजेस थे और काफ़ी सारे चेंजेस किए गए थे. एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट जिसमें कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में आधे से ज़्यादा सब्सटैंशियल चेंजेस किए गए थे. यही रीज़न है कि इसे मिनी कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन कहा जाता है. डॉक्टर बी आर अम्बेडकर and the Constituent Assembly had made certain changes in the Constitution. But why are those changes so landmark? We are going to understand subsequently as we see the different features that are there in this particular constitutional amendment. What all was added? It amended the preamble. Starting from the preamble itself, the words socialist, secular and integrity was added in preamble by this particular amendment. These are very very important terms, and ये preamble में add करने से हमारे constitutional interpretation की काफ़ी ज़्यादा clarity मिलती है. तो ये words add होने से काफ़ी ज़्यादा clarity हमारे constitutional interpretation and ultimately the law of the land में add हो जाती है. It inserted new part 4A in the constitution that is talking about fundamental duties for all the citizens of India. We have given them fundamental rights. We have provided fundamental rights in part 3. We have provided directive principles in part 4. But the duties of the citizens were not there in the Indian constitution originally. ये भी एक बहुत ही important change है जो इस amendment के through add किया गया है. Now coming to the core area, it expanded power of the parliament. Power of the parliament to do what? To amend the constitution and make it immune from judicial review. Judicial review is a very very important part of the constitution, and this is how we can keep a check on the actions of the legislature as well as the executives. But isko curtail kiya gaya tha is particular amendment mein. President was empowered to make laws during the proclamation of emergency without the consent of the states. It also curtailed the power and independence of the Supreme Court and High Courts. Again, independence of judiciary was attacked. There was a restriction on the judges. Their age and retirement of the judges was increased. Their jurisdiction and the transfers without their consent. This power was there in the hands of the government, and all such kind of things were done which were directly attacking the basic structure of the Indian constitution. And then the Article 368 Clause 5 was added that was preventing any constitutional amendment from being called in question in court or on any ground. That means constitutional amendment ko aap court mein challenge nahi kar sakte. There would not be any limitation on the constitutional power of parliament to amend the constitution. So this was how there were certain changes that were made in the constitution by this amendment, which were very controversial, which were challenged in the Supreme Court. In court of law it was challenged and it was also declared as void against the principles of Keshavanand Bharti judgment as well. That was completely invalidated. Basic structure doctrine was completely invalidated. That's why this amendment is very, very controversial as well. All these changes were reversed by the 43rd and the 44th constitutional amendment subsequently. One more landmark thing that was done in this amendment was giving primacy to DPSPs over fundamental rights. And this gave authority to the parliament to restrict or abrogate fundamental rights by amending the fundamental rights to exercise DPSPs. DPSPs kya hai? DPSPs is a tool in the hands of the government. These are directives to the government to carry out their functions, to carry out their responsibilities, but it became a tool in the hands of the government to carry out their functions, and for that it was prevailing over the fundamental rights. So even they could curtail or abrogate the fundamental rights by amending them to give primacy to DPSPs. ये भी provision को repeal कर दिया गया by the 43rd and 44th constitutional amendment. करना ही था, and now we know harmonious construction principle prevails, and what is important is overall, if even of harmonious construction you are not able to construe them together, fundamental rights will prevail over DPSPs. It also changed the relationship between executive and legislature by extending the tenure of Lok Sabha and state legislative assemblies from 5 to 6 years, making president and governor bound by the advice of the Council of Ministers. So these changes were also again repealed or reversed by the 44th Amendment. Tenure was again changed back to 5 years. So this is how this amendment was very, very lengthy and very controversial in nature as well. And all these changes were rectified later by subsequent amendments. And even in the court of law, the things were invalidated where it was required. So let us come and discuss on this iExamBees platform. Various such kind of videos will help you understand different concepts. Ya fir agar koi bhi doubts ho, to aap hume bol sakte hain. We will use this platform and discuss on these various legal topics and concepts. These are definitely helpful for your exam preparation and will give you conceptual clarity. Do reach out to us, write to us any topic you can suggest in the comment section as well. Prepare 50% faster with us at iExamBees. Download our app, check out all the features available in our iExamBees app as well. You can get the full course access. Download our app from Google Play Store. Thank you everybody. Have a nice day.